That said, he's damn near dead. Hey everybody, welcome back to Inscryption. We are right here in the Snowland. Hopefully, this time, we don't die. Last time we were here, I think we died as soon as we came in. So let's try to like keep this streak going. We got a pretty good deck here. Decent. It's not the greatest, but it is really good and it gets the job done. We'll explore the room in a bit, probably. I kind of just want to keep going with this and see how far I could get. So we're just going to go here, I guess, because I don't know. I feel like this guy gives you, I think he gives you better cards than the one on the right. I'm not too sure. So 6 HP, 4 blood. I'm going to go HP. All we need to do is pull one lucky card. There we go. That's it. See? Not bad. I don't know though. It's kind of hard to choose from these. This is good. This unkillable sigil is actually really good. Getting the card back. I'm gonna choose the opossum. Just because it has unkillable. I feel like the mantis was a smarter choice. But... oh, we have space. A pitiful opossum. Frozen. I wonder what that does. Oh, we can read this now. Nothing will happen. This bottle of goo has no use. I don't know. I'm kind of... I don't know what frozen means. I kind of want to take this. Because I didn't get to use it. It says it does nothing, but I doubt that's the case. Okay, there's our passive item. Wow, he has Moosebuck. So he's gonna be using stronger cards, I see. That's cool. I mean, off the start, what I would do is I would just place Mole Man here. And then place Opossum. Like, I kind of want to see what this does. I'm serious, you cannot use that. There's no possible use for it. I'll place it on the shelf over there for now. My advice, avoid it. Okay, good thing I used it. So it does do something. Just does what? I'm also curious. Doesn't Prince do enough damage to just straight up one-shot him? Or am I crazy? Overkill, exact. Wow. Alright. I already know where we're going now. 2, 3. Yeah, we'll take an elk. Why not? I want to go to the middle because this gave us a passive item last time. And it's like, I mean, why not? It's just a matter of who. You know what? I'm going to do it. I'm so sorry, Bullfrog, but... another bone. That's good. I'm sorry. I feel like he's been useful, but I want the beehive. So now we get 2 bones. That's actually really good. So now we could play... we could play Opossum into a Mole Man. That's not bad. We'll pop Mole Man here so he doesn't get hit. And then in terms of Opossum... I think I'll just use... but these are really good. I kind of want to save these. I don't want to, like, use it if I don't need to, but why not? Okay. Lucky draw. Undying stink bug. I can't do anything with the stink bug. That opossum's dead, sadly. I didn't think of that. We'll draw another card, see if we get something good. We got Rat King. Stinkbug is undying, so we'll just pop him here. We can, actually. Do that. Which will then kill the elk, then pop Stinkbug again. Nice. Yeah, you hit me, but it's okay. Those are both dead anyway. Do I want a card? The DOS. I can't really do anything with that. I want him to hit me. I didn't think he was gonna die. I didn't realize. Cause then he'll move over. And we'll pop a squirrel. And the undying opossum here. But then sacrifice it. And put... It'll die though if it gets hit. That's the only issue. Man, oh man, this is not going too great. Okay, I mean, it's not going terrible. I have to kill him. And then what we can do is we could pop wolf here, which will kill the elk. And then we'll put stink bug here, which will kill him. And then him there, which will kill him. Now we have pack rat. Which we can use. We could do this. Pop pack rat right here. And then replay stink bug over here. That was stupid. Stink bug might die. But we could also put a possum. Look at that. We're doing a lot better. That was really good. I forgot what the bear trap did. And I feel like we did this in an earlier video. Or, like, I think it was literally last video. But I want to go to the mushroom people again. Oh, it's this person. You won't find better pelts within 100 miles. This is where you buy the pelts or something like that? On the house. Do I have enough? I forgot what these do, if I'm gonna be honest with you. You have me gratitude. I think you take them to someone else and they buy them. I think that's how it works. I forget. Yes, I do have two of the same. What the hell would a golden pelt do? Alright, so this begs the question. If I were to combine those two, do they both... Does it get the sigil as well? Only one way to find out. Please don't remove the sigils. No, I want to see everything. Please don't remove the sigil. Look at that. But it's stronger. Look at that. That's really good. I thought we had two pack rats, don't we? Oh, we don't. I swear we had two pack rats. This is good so far. I'm proud of that. And before I find out, I'm doing the dumbest moves ever. Well, I mean... How many hits do you need to get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? I mean, if I really wanted to, I could just do this. And this will kind of just win the game automatically. Like, I know it may seem whack, but... There we go. Like, there's nothing much to it. I think this is the person you go to. Then again, there's a mushroom over there that you can combine. But I forgot what this did. So I think this is where you trade the pelts, right? Snow me some exquisite pelts. Show me. I thought that said snow. I thought she was trying to do a pun. Hair pelts? What is that? Mirror something, the power and the baron. That's cool. I kind of want to take one of those. Skunk. 3 HP. Okay, I'm gonna need a second to think about this, because this is, like, pretty damn hard. I think I'm gonna grab Alpha, and we're gonna grab this to see what it does. It doesn't even have a name. Is that a golden pelt? Magnificent. For golden pelt, I thought you'd give me something better. Mantis God, though. Wow. I'm definitely taking that. And Long Elk is the one that... Yeah, it just one-shots any creature. That's... We're taking that, too. You have my gratitude. You have my gratitude. That's really good. We'll go to the fire. I think we're full on items. Oh, no, we could use one more. We'll go to the fire. We haven't been there in a while. Why not? One damage. Let's see. Who do I want to put? I'm gonna give it to Mantis God. Why not? I wanted to give it to the opossum, but I don't know. I feel like it just, if it had the undying on it as well, it would be so good. But it doesn't. Sucks. And I'm scared now, because this is a boss that we haven't been to before. A man stood before you. A man you recognized immediately. It was the Trapper. You reached out to examine his wares, but he stopped you. Sorry, but today you will supply the pelts. Oh. So the people we come across aren't as nice as we thought. Oh, and it gets undying because it's a bug? Yo, say less. Say less. All right. Strange frog. That's not a frog. What's Steel Trap do? When a card bearing the sigil perishes, the creature opposing to it perishes as well. And you get a pell. Cool. Isn't it obvious? We just go Mantis God right here. And it hits one and two and gets them both. But then he'll die, but we have undying, so it's okay. And then as for anything else, we don't really need to do anything. Do we? No. Alright. And he's dead. I'm sorry, Mantis. We could play Pack Rat. We can indeed play Pack Rat and get a free item, or we could draw a card. We're gonna play it safe. What we're gonna do, we're gonna pop that there. At least the traps don't do damage, so theoretically I could just hit this one tile and be fine, right? Like, doing damage, wouldn't that unlock more tiles for him to hit me? And then what I could do is I could play Cockroach. This is gonna kill it, but it'll get rid of the trap. Why didn't it kill the Mantis? Let me read that again. Huh? Why didn't it kill the Mantis? That's weird. It says the opposing to it. It doesn't kill the Mantis because it's not the opposing card. Or it wasn't, now it is. We'll just... Alpha. Can you sacrifice pelts? Like, can you actually sacrifice pelts? Can't. I mean, good to know, I guess. There's like a slight issue here. I'm being hit by like everything. Mantis God is just carrying like hard. If I could just get one more bone, because I want to play. Oh, wait, I have four bones? Because I want to play Alpha, which will then boost his damage. I don't know if that was a bad idea. I hope that this boss doesn't kill my cards when they go to second phase, because then that was a bad idea. Exquisite pelts, but the cycle must continue. Let's trade. Powerful cards I'll accept only if the finest pelts. Only the finest pelts for them. Trade for what you can, but know this, the rest will stay and fight for me. I didn't want to do that. I was clicking because the... Oh, I'm gonna die. I'm taking a grizzly. I'm taking a great white. I would have chosen differently. This was an interesting idea. I think I have an idea, though. This might be crazy, right? We're gonna pop the smoke, pop a squirrel. And then we're gonna pop Pack Rat. Which will kill him. Give me another squirrel. Which will then allow me to play Black Goat. Which will then allow me to play Grizzly right here. And with that said, he's damn near dead. applaud myself. Look at that. That was good. The black goat came in clutch. Holy. Opossum didn't even show up this round. Your lives are restored. Thank you. Yes, we made it farther than before. Let's go. Perhaps one of these will entice you? I hope so. It better not be Gek for like the 18th time. It's the same cards we always see. I think we just take this one. I still don't know how to like pronounce his name properly. Uriali. I have no clue. Oh boy. Oh my gosh. With the enigmatic trapper and traitor now bleeding into snow. Wow. You persisted. I didn't want to kill them. They gave me useful stuff. You could see a light in the distance. The end is near. What do you mean the end is near? Let me see. Wait, why is there a house? We don't have any items, so I'm gonna go items. Yeah, items is a good choice, right? Yeah, they're way more useful than cards at some points. Squirrel's really useful. I'll take bones though. What does this do again? I don't know how I feel about this. Your eyes affix themselves on the small cabin. Its warm light, a beacon in the oppressive darkness of the night. Surely, this cabin marked the end of your travels, or travails. I don't know how I feel about this. Hello, jump scare? Steps away from the strange cabin, you are presented with an opportunity. I don't offer my boons to any traveler. If you are able to pass my trials, you'll be rewarded mightily. The Trial of the Swift. Three drawn cards must include a card with the Sprinter sigil. Not happening. The Trial of the Ring. If you have a ring, you pass automatically. Why would I have a ring? The Trial of the Winged. I don't have any of those. Do I have more winged creatures? No, I don't have any of these. I can't do this. It was only one. I thought it was three. I got two out of three, though, if that was the case. I'll grant you one of my most powerful boons. Cards that dramatically alter the game, and you don't even need to draw them. The Boon of the Bone Lord. You start the battle with eight bones. The Boon of the Ambidextrous. You may draw twice at the beginning of your turn. The Boon of the Forest. You start the battle with grand furs on all your spaces. It doesn't tell you the HP they have, but I would assume it's like 4 or something like that. Wow. Why is there like an 11 here with a clock? That's weird. Huh. I feel like the 8 bones is really good. But then again, Ambidextrous allows me to draw a squirrel and pull a card. I feel like the weakest one might be the trees, because that only protects you at the start. And then it allows him to stack cards on you, if you know what I mean. I don't know. This is hard. You know what? We're gonna do the Ambidextrous. We'll repeat that once more. Whoa! The Trial of Rarity. Must include a rare card. I have quite a few of those. Trial of Skins. I don't have a pelt. The Trial of the Finned. I have only like one. I feel like my best chance is Rarity. Please. RNG. There it is. Pack Rat coming in clutch. Boons time. The Boon of Magpie's Eye. When you draw from your deck, you may choose any card in your deck to draw. That's really good. Trees. the Boon of Goat's Blood. You start the battle with a black goat. That's really good. But I feel like being able to choose whatever card I want allows me to play how I want, which will then allow me to basically win easier than the black goat card. Because if I don't get something that needs three blood in time, then the black goat becomes useless and it'll die, if you think about it. I'm gonna go with this. I'm not sure if that's a bad idea. Thank you, mysterious giant hand. I'm looking left and right to see if there's anyone here. Hey! You managed to get both of my boons. I rarely say this, but I am impressed. I'm impressed too. You have been a worthy adversary. But unfortunately, I must soon put you to death, huh? You sure about that? You took your time out there. Yeah, I did. And I'm itching for another game. Are you ready to play? I guess I have no choice. I hope you are adequately prepared. Perhaps one more to be safe. Oh, I don't like this. I don't like this. I don't feel like we're gonna get this first try. So he's everyone. We still have Undying on our cards. Good. What is that? Amalgam? Music do be bumping though. The music do be bumping. Okay. What I want to try to go for like a one hit kill. So if I snip this mole, theoretically it would get him killed so I could go straight to second phase. But I'm not sure if I want to speed that. Like speed run per se. That was probably the stupidest move I've pulled since the start. But we won't know, will we? The reason I did it is to... I'm trying to think of where I want to place this guy. I don't really know. I'm gonna do this so he takes the damage. You capably endured the onslaught of rare creatures, but the true challenge was forthcoming. Shadowy figures appeared before you, and their eyes glimmered a recognition of kinship, but colored by guilt. They were betraying you. I remember that one fondly. Huh, Jerry and Casey. This is just lovely, isn't it? Just see everyone. I'm gonna be honest, I don't know who I want. I think I know. I'm gonna do Opossum, right? I'm gonna grab Prince. But I think we're gonna pass. Because I feel like our people are fine with the way they are. Unless I do this. You can actually place Prince down, grab this up, and then use this opossum. Oh, I'm an idiot. I should have used Mantis God. Crap. It's okay. It's whatever. Don't you dare hook my cards with gold. Or turn them into gold, I mean. I want him. I'll go. Now you want to go? Before you didn't want to play, now you want to play. Well, we'll do now, right? Where's the card? We'll take Wolf. We have a crap ton of bones, I'll tell you that. I don't really want to get rid of Mole Man. Oh! My card's Undying. I forget about that. Ha! Oh. you thought you'd get me? Not today. Two down. Why'd the music stop? This damn moon. It's dramatic, yes? Yeah. But it provides no value to my board. I wonder, don't you dare. Now that is value. That's not what I expected. 40 HP? And we have Mole Man sitting here doing zero? Let's see, let me guess, he hits all four cards? A card bearing this sigil will strike each opposing space that is occupied by a creature. It will strike directly if no creatures are opposed to it. That's death. At the beginning of its owner's turn, a card bearing this sigil will put small creatures like squirrels into orbit. So does that just like take the card for defense? And he has air defense. But does he defend against submerged? We need our biggest damage cards now. Doesn't this like one shot? Wouldn't that technically kill him in one hit? Like if you think about it. We're gonna take Alpha. And then we're also gonna take this like squid thing because we don't know what it does. Like I'm kinda curious. But should I kill Mole Man for it? I think it just reflects their damage. That's what my guess would be. You know what? I'll pass the turn. Okay. That's not bad. We'll take Cockroach. Just in case things get bad, these two revive themselves. Also, he has this, which makes it do less damage, and it only does one. But for now, since he's gonna die... Wait, no. We're gonna do this, and then we're gonna place Mantis here. And that should just kill him. You really destroyed the moon. Yeah, I'm surprised I did too. What are you gonna throw at me, the sun? It's just to finish me off. Go on. I don't trust you. I feel like you're playing with me. That's a lot of damage. There's no way we just did that. Is that it?
Oh my, did I just... I think I just beat him.
His famous last words. Oh. I guess we just go through it? Okay. How do I go to the next video? How do I go back? What's the back button? Let me out. Oh.
Hey there, card gamers. I'm the Lucky Carter, and this is another pack opening video. Today, I am opening Catch Monsters packs and digging for that epic, shiny Transcendog! And here I'll add some crazy VFX with lightning bolts or something. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I am about to open my first pack.
This whole game wasn't just a guy sitting in front of a green screen, right? I really hope not. I'm gonna be sad. That's what it's looking like.
Okay. And our first rare is a Birchkin. Not exactly a viable competitive card, but hey, it's a pretty one. All right. Next pack.
Are these like real cards? Because I never heard of them before.
I gotta say, these cards are feeling extra silky today. I mean... They're so smooth. Not sure what they're doing down there at the card factory, but these are feeling good in my hands. Okay.
What do you mean by that?
Let's see what we got here. Some jank cards. Maybe a few additions to my draft cube. We'll see. And our rare for this pack is...
Is it a card that we've used before? No.
Not exactly riveting so far, but we have many packs to go. Next pack, here we come! Just cut out this part.
Okay. I'm curious on where this is going.
Hey there, card gamers! I'm the Lucky Carter, and this is a vintage pack opening video. Today I'm opening a few super rare old packs I snagged at a garage sale. I've got four packs of Inscryption. You would not believe the deal I got on these. Now, not
there it is.
Remember this game. I'm barely old enough to have seen these going around in my childhood. For whatever reason, they only did one set of these cards and then stopped printing them. There's not
I wonder why.
Them anymore, but at the rate I got them for, there's not really much to lose. That being said, a foil Mantis God goes for a couple hundred bucks, so fingers crossed.
I had a Mantis God, and he did work. Mantis God was literally
cool.
The best.
Definitely stands the test of time. And our rare for this pack is Blue Mage. Cool looking card, but not going to be worth very much. All right. Let's see what we got going on in the second pack. This pack has been opened. And... resealed. Hope no one snuck the rare out of it.
As long as nothing's missing, I guess it don't matter that much now, does it? Now, where is this going?
Honestly, who opens and reseals a pack? Yeah. There's a set of coordinates on this card. Looks like they were drawn on with a pen. 49 degrees north, 123 degrees west.
I hope that's not your coordinates, because that'd be pretty messed up.
I'd have to check, but I think that's pretty nearby.
Huh. Is this how we found the cabin?
I'm out here.
Alone?
My best life.
Yeah, let's go alone into the forest on coordinates
and shovel
from a card. Cool.
Always come prepared, kids. Alright.
Prepared will be bringing somebody with you. Whew. Or a weapon.
There we go. Yeah. Okay. Whew. Getting close. I think. Assuming there is a thing to get close to. This very well may be a massive waste of...
Okay.
All right.
He still seems fine, so
that's
I don't know what the deal with that is.
You always bring an extra battery, boys and girls.
Oh, okay.
Every time. You gotta come prepared.
I still don't get why you'd go in the forest alone. That seems like a really stupid idea. But I mean, go ahead.
All right. This is it.
How did you know to bring a shovel? It never said it was buried treasure.
We dig. I give a 75% chance it's a rock. But only one way to find out.
What's with the poking? Is that like a thing people do before they dig? They poke around?
What the fuck? Is that? Oh my god, you guys, I can't believe it. There's actually something here.
Can't really tell what that is. Oh.
What? What the fuck? Guys, are you seeing this? I'm a little confused.
I'm confused as well. Started walking kind of fast there. Is he really trying to sell it? I couldn't tell if he was trying to sell it.
Time to figure out what's on this thing.
Hold up. I'm getting flashbacks. The fact that you even have something to play that is crazy. What? So we are him. I do not celebrate often, and I seldom give gifts. But you, Challenger, you are worthy. I'm so confused. I'm not good with this, like, confusion or whatever, lore stuff. I don't know. Please, do not be polite. Dig in. Why would I want that? Oh, is there something wrong? Your prize awaits. Very well. Come with me. I don't really want that. I don't even know what that is. Are you gonna take a picture of me and kill me again? Not this time, Buckaroo. No, I will need that. You, Challenger, are a champion, and I wish to commemorate your victory. Are you kidding me? Was I supposed to, like, put film in the camera before I got to this point so that I don't die? So does this mean I have to go through all of this again? I have a feeling this is literally death. I guess I'm dead. Do not despair. You are a winner. I feel like I didn't do something at some point. I don't think that's how the game is supposed to end. That makes me think that we were supposed to put film in the camera beforehand or something like that. So that's how you figure that one out.
Whoa.
The last challenger managed to defeat me. Yeah, okay. A rare event. Go and ask how they did it. You'll find them hanging from the door over there. Literally? Or figuratively? Here's your deck. Study it. Ah, not again! The start feels very compact with, like, a bunch of stuff. Ah, that was such a good deck. I'm so sad. Now there's a raven here. There wasn't a raven there before. It says it's hanging by the door. Oh. That sucks. We didn't actually, like, win. I'm sad now. I guess we could see what's in here. Wasn't it? Crap. I would need to look at the video footage to get this code, because I already forgot. I thought it was this. Wow, I can't. Well, first off, I can't believe we beat it. It wasn't as hard as I thought, the final boss, because I guess we had a really, really good deck, and we got the boons. Without the boons, we probably wouldn't have done that. But damn, I guess that's it, guys. I guess we beat Inscryption, but not really. We're definitely going back in this to finish it the true way or whatnot, and I guess we'll see what happens from there. But if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. Bye, everybody. Thank you.